Once again, it's your boy. You are in the kitchen with Chef R. Allen, cooking made easy. Today I'm doing a sandwich day. Today is a sandwich day. So I'm doing a Philly cheesesteak grilled cheese sandwich. It's real simple and easy to make, but oh so delicious to eat. So we're gonna bring this down. So I got some extra thin chuck steak, you know, cut thin. You can get whatever beef you use, you know, and shred it and cut it yourself if you want. But like I said, I'm trying to make it real simple and easy. Okay, we're coming down, and I got the skillet going with the oil. It's a Philly cheesesteak grilled cheese sandwich, guys. I got the green peppers. I got the green peppers, I got the onions. We're gonna saute that. And loosen that up a little bit. Get a little salt. Loosen that up a little bit. As always, the recipe is at the bottom of the description. And right here, I'm just doing one sandwich for you guys, but like I said, it'll be at the bottom of the description. This is number four. You want to saute this. I'm using this skillet here to do my bread. Of course, you got the Texas toast. Okay, while that's sauteing, I like to put a little Worcestershire sauce in my beef. So we're gonna shred that. Get that out the way. Cut nice and thin for you guys. Let you guys see that. I like a little fat on it, of course. To me, that's the flavor. Put a little Worcestershire sauce with it. Mix that all in. Nice and thin. I mean, you can cut it a little, if you guys want to cut it a little thinner or chop more. But I'm doing it because this is going to be a grilled cheese sandwich for me. So I want a little pieces to it, nice. I don't want it too shredded. I got my steak seasoning. I got my provolone and cheddar. You know, of course, Philly cheesesteak with a provolone, but I still want to have an orange cheese. Got a little steak seasoning. And you can use whatever seasoning you want. I mean, Philly cheesesteak, steak seasoning. I like the steak seasoning with that. You can cover it up if you want, but this won't take long to cook. If you want, like if you wanted to put a little beef base, you can. I'm doing a little Worcestershire, so it works both. It works both. It leaves a little moisture. And plus the seasoning tenderizes it for me. Guys, You guys are awesome as always. Thank you guys for liking and subscribing. And just thank you guys for your support. And if you need any requests, I love the requests and the replies I've been getting. You know, you guys are awesome. And just thank you guys. Okay. We'll do a little more seasoning. And this is, I'm using chuck steak. Thin sliced chuck steak. Like I said, you can use any steak, whatever's in the house or whatever, you know, leftover something. I'm just showing you guys, let's bring this in closer. So I'm bringing this in closer, and then I want to get a lid and let it simmer. Because I want the steak nice and tender, and I don't want it to be fast cooked. So we're going to put the lid on here. I'm going to let that cook. And in the meantime, we'll be doing the garlic bread. We'll be making the toast. Okay, let's see. We'll start off with the butter. I'll bring that over here. Start you guys off with the butter and the bread. While we got the beef cooking. Cheese melt and the meat will be done. Beautiful. Give me a little more butter. Gotta have a little more butter. Okay, we're gonna make the Texas toast. The thicker the better. So I got nice pieces of Texas toast. And I like to put them on. Sit that there. Let that heat up. Guys, it's real simple, easy to make. Wow, this is, wow, that's cooking. Oh yeah. One nice and tender. I like the chuck steak, but you can cut it real nice and thin. Doesn't take long to cook. We'll bring that in. Okay. We got the beef. Nice and tender. Oh, yes. My green peppers and my onions. You can use mushrooms, too, if guys want to do mushrooms. Or whatever vegetables. Whatever you do, whatever vegetables you make with your Philly cheesesteaks. Oh, yes. Yes. You see that, guys? You see that? That's the color you want. That's the color you want, right there. Nice and tender. That color, that's, oh, man. Yes, yes. Okay. You see how nice and... You can do a lot of things with a grilled cheese. I'm gonna start you off. Mushrooms. I mean, we're going to put the green peppers and the onions. Cut this off. You know what? We're just going to pile it up high. Oh, man. I got to taste this again. You got your green peppers, your onions. And I can take whatever vegetables you want to use. That there is not your mama's grilled cheese. This here, guys, is my Philly steak grilled cheese sandwich. Oh, so easy to make and oh, so delicious to eat. Until next time, guys, as always, you're in the kitchen with Chef R. Allen with Cooking Made Easy. Until next time, guys, you're in the kitchen with Chef R. Allen. Cooking Made Easy. Thank you, guys.